So there have been some rumors flying around recently about a new entry into the Metal Gear Solid series, or at least some kind of remake or remaster of the first game, and some people going as far as to believe that there might be a potential remake of the first three games, and Metal Gear Solid 4 just getting a HD port to PlayStation 4 and 5. There's also the rumor that there is something going on behind the scenes with Konami and Microsoft, whether it's Konami just giving Microsoft a license for one of their IPs, if Konami is giving exclusivity to Microsoft with either this potential Metal Gear Solid game or the also rumored Silent Hill games that are also apparently upcoming. Understandably, there has been a lot of worry for the Metal Gear Solid franchise, and without Kojima, fans are wondering what would become of the Metal Gear Solid franchise without his vision helming development. And understandably, a lot of people in the fanbase are looking at Metal Gear Solid Survive as a benchmark for the potential catastrophe of any upcoming Metal Gear Solid entries if Konami are actually planning on resurrecting what is essentially one of their many dead or dying IPs. Fans across the board have mixed feelings and what they would like to see or what they think shouldn't belong in a Metal Gear Solid game is very varied as you go person to person and look at everyone's individual preferences. So here I am just going to spout off a few ideas of what I think could potentially make a good Metal Gear Solid sequel, going under the assumption that it's going to be a Metal Gear Solid 6, not a Metal Gear Solid 1 remake. I am one of the people who believe that going back to a pre-Phantom Pain style of gameplay would potentially be better for the series. Being able to focus all of your attention on one story in one major location, it means you can really focus and invest yourself into a story without having to flop around between locations. I wasn't super fond of Metal Gear Solid 4's country hopping, even though that was a major point of the story. I really wasn't a fan of Metal Gear Solid 5 and how, even though you already had one huge empty area to explore in Afghanistan, you then had basically the exact same thing with a few more trees in Africa. Metal Gear Solid 5, The Phantom Pain, was fun. It really had some good gameplay mechanics, it had a lot of opportunity and variety available to you as a player, and it allowed for some really stupid moments, some really funny moments, and through all the cringe of the dialogue and the fact that this game was blatantly unfinished, you could still have a good time. The real main issue, as I've already mentioned, is even though you have two large sandboxes to explore, with the exception of maybe some key locations and the odd checkpoints scattered around, these worlds were empty. Now, I get you could make the argument that one of them is on the savannah plains of Africa and the other one is literally in the desert of Afghanistan, but if you're gonna make an open world, put something in it. I get Kojima's always been about having those weird and off-the-cuff ideas, so it was probably very intentional to keep the world empty in Metal Gear Solid 5, but a fun game that does not make. I'll come back to this in a little bit as it ties into a point I've got coming up. But I also feel like we need to return to Solid Snake, not Naked Snake or Venom Snake or Raiden. For those wondering how we can do that given how Metal Gear Solid 4 ends, I think it's a very simple fix. We can set the game between Metal Gear Solid 1 and 2, when Snake's new group, Philanthropy, are in the early days of setting themselves up as a non-government organization. We could also reintroduce characters like Mei Ling or Nastasha Romanenko, seeing as they were also members of the group. If that doesn't float your boat, you could even go between Metal Gear Solid 2 and 4, showing how Snake is reacting to the early signs of his rapid aging, and have the plot set around chasing down Ocelot around the world, a la MGS4. This contradicts my first point of a singular setting, but it does allow for a variety of locations and scenarios without downtime just being driving to the next area. Now, obviously something we are going to have is a new antagonistic group, be it a PMC, a new core, but this has basically been tradition in almost every Metal Gear game at this point. We had Foxhound, Dead Cell, the Cobra Unit, and the Skulls. We could have a group made specially by Ocelot to take down Snake, similar to the Beauty and the Beast Corps of Metal Gear Solid 4. And just like every previous antagonistic group beforehand, each member could be a specialist in a certain field. Maybe they can be based around their country of origin and a typical depiction of an ideal soldier in that region. For example, we could have a Viking type member called Odinson, who uses nanomachines and can enter a near invincible berserker state. He comes equipped with a minigun called Gungnir as a sort of callback to Vulcan Raven. We could have an ex-Mossad operative codenamed Basham, who basically is a carbon copy of Snake, and you have to combat an enemy with a very similar mindset and skill set who uses basically the same tactics as Snake. Getting sort of back on track with plot, I do again genuinely believe a game style similar to 1, 2, 3 and 4 would be better for the series, considering Kojima isn't there now to juggle all of the absurdities and convoluted themes. A focused story about the early days of philanthropy and how they've discovered and located the location of a new Metal Gear being built, but then realizing they may be in over their heads now without government backing, ultimately overcoming the new limitations and becoming the philanthropy we know in Metal Gear Solid 2 and 4. If we did go on another globe-hopping style adventure with Snake and pals, maybe we could have 3 or 4 smaller areas with their own base of operations and is watched over by one of the new enemy unit leaders, sort of like a Hitman version of Metal Gear Solid, which then would ultimately lead into a showdown with that faction's new Metal Gear and or a showdown with the members themselves. Now, new enemies are fun, new characters are fun, new playable characters in a Metal Gear Solid game, it's a mixed bag. While I personally don't have a problem with Raiden, I much prefer Snake as a character and do not want another last minute blindside of a new playable character mid-story. I also think the removal of any mechanic like Drebin Store should just go as well. It never made sense to me that in the middle of a battle on a robot boat thingy, we could just airdrop an arseload of guns and ammo. Metal Gear Solid was always about the on-site procurement of weapons, items, and ammo. That's more or less one of the very first lines you hear Snake say in the intro of Metal Gear Solid 1. And then having access to everything ever made ever at the push of a button was something I didn't think made sense and actively avoided as much as possible while playing through Guns of the Patriots. My final and the biggest point I could make, can someone please give David Hayter a call and see if he's busy? Because I think everyone and their mum was thrown off by Keitha Sutherland's voice coming out of Snake. We really need to go back to our boy Snake, and Snake needs his boy David speaking through his mouth hole. But after watching a YouTube video recently of a clip where David Hayter basically sounds like he is aware that something is happening in the Metal Gear Solid franchise, but doesn't seem to have any indication of what's going on, is an indication in and of itself that he potentially won't be coming back. There's the off chance that if they are remaking the first game again, they might just remaster the audio. David has said himself that they wouldn't be able to use the files from the first game, but the remake for the GameCube has the better audio. They already re-recorded the entire game at a much higher quality. And then if there is a new Metal Gear Solid coming up in the next few years, right now they haven't asked David to voice anything, which means if they're is a Metal Gear Solid in the works, it's still very early days, as voice acting tends to be one of the final things that gets done. But we'll just have to wait and see, because as most things are when it comes to Konami games, especially in recent weeks and months, it's all rumor, it's all speculation. Although David Hayter himself and a few other credible sources in the leaking scene have said that there's something more behind this than most other rumors. They went as far as to say in one video I watched on the matter that this has gone from a baseless rumor to basically an industry rumor, which those tend to be a little bit more realistic in terms of bearing fruit for a franchise or a series. as much as I could go on about more and more things, no, I didn't go into too much detail on most of these things. That's because really I haven't fleshed much out in my overall thoughts on this, and I don't want to start putting ideas down just to ultimately disappoint myself by not getting the things I think would be cool. Just as always, these are my thoughts and my opinions. I know the fan base for Metal Gear Solid is very passionate, and I'd love to know what you guys would think about the possibility for a new Metal Gear Solid, the possibility for the remake of one or three of the original games. What do you think would be great for the Metal Gear Solid series going forward? Let me know down below, because I can't wait to get stuck into this one specifically with you guys. And if you haven't already, please feel free to hit that subscribe button. I do videos like this quite frequently. I am also trying to get back into the review side of videos. I just haven't had much time with those right now, but thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.